Hi everyone, myself Naveen, I am the maths mentor and today we will discuss about factorization. I mean we can also call it as splitting the middle term. In our previous video we have discussed how to factorize a quadratic polynomial if the coefficient of x square is 1. If the coefficient of x square is 1, how to find roots of the given quadratic polynomial? Now this is the another case, that is, students listen here carefully. Here the coefficient of x square is 4. In our previous video, we have discussed one of the problem, x square plus 5x plus 6. You try to observe here the difference between these two polynomials. What is the difference here? Here, in this polynomial, coefficient of x square is 1 and the constant term is 6. So actually we have to multiply constant term with the coefficient of x square. I mean 6 into 1, 6 1 is 6. Okay? If it is 1, we will not do, directly we will take constant term only. But whereas in this case, if you observe here the coefficient of x square is 4 children, then we have to multiply constant term, which is minus 1, and the coefficient of x square is 4. That 2 we have to multiply. I mean minus 1 into coefficient of x square is 4. Minus 1 into 4, that is minus 4 children. Are you understanding what we have to do here? We have to multiply constant term with coefficient of x square. Constant term is minus 1 into coefficient of x square is 4. Minus 1 into 4, that is equal to minus 4. So, here that, now we need to consider constant term as minus 4. Right? So again we need to split the middle term into two numbers, n1 and n2. What is the first condition? Sum of two numbers must be middle term and the product of two numbers must be constant term. Right? So the factors of 4 are 4 1 ja 4, 2 2 ja 4. But the condition will be satisfied here, 4 and 1. But if you observe here, we have minus 4 students. So, I can write as minus 4 into 1, minus 4 into, I mean, plus 4, because here the middle term is plus 3x children. So, let us consider plus 4 into minus 1. Why? Because plus into minus minus 4, 1 is 4. Product of two numbers is constant term. Second condition. And the first condition is, if I add 4 to minus 1, how much? 4 plus minus 1, 4 plus minus 1, that is equal to how much? 3, right? From 4, if you subtract 1, 4 minus 1, again you will get the middle term. Okay? Now, I can write as 4x square and this 3x I can write as 4x minus 1x. Children, 4x minus 1x, 4 minus 1, 3x. And here the constant term is minus 1. Right? Now, what is the meaning of 4x square? 4x square meaning is 4 into x children. Right? So, from these two terms, I can take 4x as common. If I take 4x as common, 4x into x, you will get 4x square plus, here nothing in the sense, I can take as 1, so I can take plus 1. Right? Now, we have here minus 1x, minus 1. From these two terms, let me take minus 1 as common, minus 1 into x, minus 1x, minus into plus, minus into plus, minus 1 1 1 1. Yes, now we have x plus 1. I can take x plus 1 as common, so I have here 4x and minus 1. I can write as 4x minus 1. So what are the factors of 4x square plus 3x minus 1? That is x plus 1 and 4x minus 1. Okay, let us observe one more question. x square minus 5x minus 2. Again, here the constant term is minus 2 and the coefficient of x square is 3. I mean minus 2 into 3. Minus 2 into 3, 2 3 is 6 students. That is minus 6. Now, what is the middle term here? Middle term is minus 5x. I mean, if we add, this is number 1 and this is number 2, we are splitting the middle term into two numbers. When we add number 1 and number 2, we must get minus 5x. When we multiply number 1 and number 2, we should get, that is middle term, right? So minus 6, I can write as minus 2 minus 6. We got 3x square minus 5x minus 2, minus 2 into 3 minus 6. So what are the factors of 6? 6 1 is 6, right? 2 3 is 6 also, but that condition is not satisfied. Let me take 6 and 1. Now let us check whose signs. Here minus we have, so let me take minus 6 into plus 1. Right, minus into plus, minus 6, 1 just 6. Product of two numbers. And coming to second first condition, if I add minus 6 and plus 1, minus 6 plus 1, which is equal to how much children? Minus 5, right? So the factors are minus 6 and 1. So the first term is here 3x square minus 5x, I can write as minus 6x plus 1x and minus 2, right? So what is the meaning of 3x square? 3 into x children minus, what is the meaning of 6x? I can write as 3 into 2 into x children, right? Now coming to observe here, we have plus 1x. 1x meaning is 1 into x minus, we have 2. 2 I can write as 2 into 1. Okay. So here we have 3. Again we have x. X I can take 3x as common. If I take 3x as common, what is left over here children? We have x minus 2. Right? So from these two terms, I took 3x as common, 3x into x, 3x square, minus 3 into 2, 6x. Now from these two terms, I can take plus 1 as common. If I take plus 1 as common, what is left over here children? We have x minus 2, right? So from this 1 I took common, we have x, 1 into minus 2, minus 2. Okay, now we have x minus 2 here. Let me take x minus 2 as common. I have here 3x and here I have 1. So what are the factors of 3x square minus 5x minus 2? That is x minus 2 into 3x plus 1. Right, now let us consider one more question. That is 2x square plus 3x plus 1. Again, here the coefficient of x square is 2 and the constant term is 1. We need to multiply constant term with the coefficient of x square. 1, 2 is 2. Now, let us find out the factors of 2. That is 2, 1 is 2. If I add 2 into 1, again I'll get 2 only. If I multiply 2 and 1, I'll get 2. If I add 2 to 1, that is 3. Right? So that only we are getting. Here our middle term is 3x. If I divide this 3x into two numbers, n1 and n2. So what are the two numbers? Let us write 2x square. The first number is 2x. And the second number is 1x. And the constant term is 1 here, children. Right? Now, from these two terms, I can take 2x as common. 2x into x, 2x square. 2x into 1, 2x. Now from these two terms, I can take 1 as common, 1 into x, 1x, 1 into 1, 1. Now here we have x plus 1. If I take x plus 1 as common, I have 2x plus 1. So what are the factors of 2x square plus 3x plus 1? That is x plus 1 and 2x plus 1. Children, I hope this concept, which is the coefficient of x square is some number, then how to factorize the given quadratic polynomial. Okay, I hope this concept is very clear to you. Please hit subscribe button, like it and share it, children. Thank you.